There is a current fight to prevent schools from accomplishing its purpose of education. Why should the beliefs of some prevent children from learning the intricate process taking place around them?
In fact, all players of the video games benefit from everyday skills. Games should be looked at as good, not evil.
An eye for an eye makes the world blind. Gandhi. At the heart of racism is their religious assertion that God made a creative mistake.
Dahl believes that animal cruelty is very bad and upsetting. First off, animal abusers are hurting an innocent animal that's just trying to survive. Animals are living creatures that deserve to have a happy life just like humans.
Most first-time parents are scared, but how does a single parent feel about having to take both roles in the house?
When my English teacher started talking about opt-ed, I started thinking about the issues of prostitution and how it impacts society. I know nothing about this firsthand. I've been thinking a lot about women's rights lately after studying Elizabeth Cady Stanton. I started thinking about and understanding that having an open, healthy conversation about sex can benefit women and men. Sex work needs to be looked at with an open mind. Our society needs to accept the role of prostitution and its benefits to ensuring a healthy and safe sexual community.
Refugees among children are a fast-growing problem all over the world. There is a fast-increasing problem with the large growing number of refugees, including abandoned refugee children and limited shelter.
Every so often, as a child who is still learning, I forget my parents are still learning too. Maybe the choices your parents made shaped you into the person you are today, whether you agree with those choices or not. Maybe your parents made bad decisions, such as confining love and affection, comparing you to your peers, or addiction.
Gender bias of the 17th century in English literature. Gender bias in almost any or all fields of work is still a very prominent problem in today's work life as it was hundreds, if not thousands, of years ago. Though it is managed better and men are now held mostly accountable for their actions and words, the problem is still there, although it holds no ground over the 17th century. All the problems we have now are attributed to making up for past mistakes.
I walked into school on a gloomy day in October, and masks were required. I was shocked to see everyone was talking about how the masks were hard to breathe in and how they would affect so much we do in our school / and our lives. As soon as I walked into my homeroom classroom, the teacher talked about the pandemic and how it was a serious problem.
With schools being canceled and the constant transportation issues, both can disrupt the workforce of schools.
Tattoos don't define a person who they are as a human. They are the ultimate form of self-expression.
Some of this experience that I had with animal abuse was with my cat. My cat, Peanut, had a family before we adopted him. We know his first family before neglected and abused him.
Finally, I remember I was eating my breakfast, but I could not eat, and my mom had gotten me a yummy muffin. I could not eat because the burning sensation made me feel physically sick, and yet I couldn't tell my mom until I got to school, and I was acting differently. My teacher at the time noticed the behavior. I was called over and finally broke down, like a slow tumble of glass falling. I could not breathe. This was my first heartbreak without dating, and I was lost. Come to find out, only 10 to 20 kids knew about it, and it felt like the entire world.
Are you someone who struggles with anxiety? What's one small thing you can do to feel better? As someone who has lived with anxiety for the majority of my life, I've had to learn to find ways to let go of my anxiety after it passes. When I would get anxious, a lot of times the feeling of fear that came with my anxiety attack would stay with me for the rest of the day. I didn't realize that exercise could help me get through this until I started doing dance 4 days a week. I would go to dance right after school, and after a hard day, I would be extremely unmotivated to do ballet. My dance teacher would always say, "Leave it at the door, Charlie," and I would have to walk in not thinking about what had happened at school, but think about the combination of movements that I was being taught. Pouring all my energy into learning the movements would eventually allow me to forget about the emotions and thoughts that were swimming in my brain. Dance offered me a way to release my emotions and anxiety and come back feeling stronger instead of weak.
Lost in a sea of unstoppable waves, no control, a chemical imbalance that will try to define my entire life. Kids will be born with chemical imbalances that won't be found until they reach young adulthood, and sometimes will never be found. I felt isolated, lost, and confused why people don't like me as a kid. They weren't fond of me because I was different. As a young adolescent trying to navigate a dark ocean, light almost feels like a trick. The storm's eye is the most delicate part of the storm, but as soon as the storm moves, you are struck with all its power. Life will never be a game of fairness. Life is so unpredictable. Every decision and action you make affects your life.
I believe that children should not have to go through this process alone. I believe they should be allowed to be with their families whom they feel safe with. I believe that children should not be in danger of sexual abuse. I believe families shouldn't be separated.
With time, I grew to embrace the shadows that I felt clouded my judgment. I didn't want to hold on to hate and suffering. Pain is always there, but you choose to suffer.
In this life, you are granted one thing for sure, and that's you. Something that will change and evolve frequently, much like everything else in life. But you can never lose sight of you.
Karma is simply energy that our intentional thoughts and actions create. I believe in karma. Do you?
Why couldn't I be lighter, with lighter hair and prettier eyes? How come people didn't like the way I looked? I was younger asking myself these questions.
The art of forgiveness. Do it with passion, and don't forget that forgiving is all about you letting go and growing and moving forward in life happily and freely.
Humor is the best medicine. It breaks the silence in a room, it can make a person smile, and it can even make someone believe in joy again. Humor brings back joy from past memories.